Taken up with the rapture of the church, and now we are in heaven. Verse 1 of Revelation 4 starts that John has to come up into heaven and look. So where is he? He's in heaven and he's seeing the 24 elders. The 24 elders represents the true believers in Jesus Christ, including the people from the Old Testament who believed. Because it is not only under the law, because Father Abraham already believed before the law was given, and his faith was righteousness. So it includes all the Old Testament, all persons from the Old Testament who believed. So the persons who accepted Jesus Christ as Savior, because also in the Old Testament they recognized that they were a sinner and accepted Jesus Christ as Lord through faith. And verse 2, and at once John was in the Spirit in heaven. In the Spirit, not in body. No, not in body. Because nobody can enter heaven with a sinful body. At the rapture of the church, we receive a new sinless body without diseases. And with that sinless body, one is able to enter heaven, but not with this sinful body. Nor John, so he was lifted up in the spirit in heaven. And who is sitting there at the throne in Revelation 4? He who sat on the throne appears like jasper and carnelian, and around the throne was a rainbow that looked like an emerald, and an emerald is green. Carnelian differs from jasper in that jasper will always be opaque, whereas carnelian is translucent. Carnelian may be nearly opaque, but that still let light through when fueled from the ashes. Jasper usually exhibits multicolored patterns and splotches which are lacking in carnelian. The carnelian is a precious stone, ruby red, and a species of chalcedony. Its color is flesh hoods red, varying from the purest flesh color to a deep blood red. The carnelian stone represents a stone of motivation and endurance, leadership and courage. It portrays God as our Redeemer. Jasper represents as a stone of grounding and stability, providing comfort and security, health and strength. It portrays God's absolute purity and perfection. The Israeli high priest wore the jasper, the sardian, the carnelian, and 9 other gemstones on his chest. Remember, the high priest had daily the breastplate with the 12 stones on his chest, which represent the complete Israelites, the complete 12 tribes. He was wearing it on his chest, meaning that our high priest Jesus Christ wears us believers on his chest. He prays for us. And each of these gemstones represented a tribe on the chest, symbolically on the high priest in the Old Testament. And John also indicates that an emerald rainbow circled around God's throne. An emerald is green and symbolizes life. The first rainbow, where did we encounter the first rainbow? Correctly, after the flood at Noah. It was a covenant between Noah and God that God will never destroy earth again through a flood. This is a token of God's promise. God will not destroy the earth again through a flood, but in the great tribulations, thorn of God will come again in other destructions. 1/3 of the earth will be destroyed. There will be flames. There will be comets, stars falling on the earth. And recently we have seen falling a lot of comets from the stars. But luckily, so far, no destruction. But in the great tribulation, the comets will much be user. They will not be burnt up in the atmosphere, and they will fall on Earth and destroy. There will be tsunamis. Many people will be killed. 1/3 of the ships will be destroyed. But here, in Revelation 4, there is the emerald rainbow around God's thrones, which indicate God's promise of eternal life is guaranteed. So what is the meaning of these 24 elders and the four living creatures? The 24 elders we can divide in two groups, each group of 12 elders. The patriarchs, the 12 patriarchs of Israel. So let's go to Deuteronomy 27, the verses 12 and 13. These 12 elders are the patriarchs who will judge each tribe of Israel. And they represent them also each tribe. Deuteronomy 27, the verses 12 and 13. The sons of Leah, Reuben, Jacob's firstborn, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, and Zebulun. The two tribes of Rachel, Joseph and Benjamin. The sons of Bilhah, Rachel's handmaid, Dan and Naphtali. And the sons of Zilpa, Leah's handmaid, Gad and Aser. But these represents the 12 elders, the 12 tribes of Israel. So we are left with another 12 elders. Well, they are the 12 apostles. The 12 apostles appointed by Jesus, and the traitor Judas was replaced by the apostle Paulus on the road to Damascus by Jesus Christ, and they represent the complete church, and they will judge the church. And why they? Well, they lived together with Jesus Christ. They know how hard it is to believe. They themselves asked to Jesus, give us more faith. So they were taught by Jesus. They know the commandments of Jesus. They have given the four gospels. They have given the letters. They have given to the church the teaching of Jesus. So they will judge the believers in Jesus Christ, because they themselves has that experience. They are taught, they have lived under sin, they know how it is to live under sin and to be tempted by Satan. And they were clad in white garments. In heaven, all believers are cleansed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, and therefore we are blameless, white, without sin, and without a sinful body. Let's go to verse 5. Before the throne burn 7 torches of fire. 7, the number of perfectness, completeness, fire, the Holy Spirit. So here is the Holy Spirit with the church in heaven, no longer on earth. In verse 6, before the throne, there it was like a sea of glass, like crystal and around the throne, on each side of the throne, are four living creatures, full of eyes, in front and behind them. Wilfred, fantasy. Is it? Is it fantasy, this beast? Don't we know the beast of Star Wars, Star Trek? We know that these creatures exist, and it isn't the first time they are mentioned. We already counted them in Ezekiel 1 verses 22, over the heads of the living creatures, there was the likeness of a firmament, shining like crystal, spread out above the heads. Verse 26, and above the firmament, over the heads, there was the likeness of a throne, in appearance like a soldier, and seated above the likeness of a throne was the likeness as of a human form. And on each side of these four living creatures, full of eyes in front and behind, living creature like a lion, the second like an ox, the third living creature with the face of a human, and the fourth living creature like a flying eagle. And the four living creatures, each of them had six wings and are full of eyes all around. In Ezekiel 10 verse 14 tells us, and everyone had four faces. The first was the face of a seer, the second was the face of a man, the third the face of a lion, and the fourth, the face of an eagle. Equally, here, in Revelation 4. And let's go to Isaiah 6, verses 1 to 3. I saw the Lord, and we are seeing the Lord sitting here in Revelation, but there already Isaiah saw the Lord sitting upon the throne, high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. And above him stood the seraphim, each had six wings. And with two he covered his face, with two he covered his feet, and with two he flew. The description, later on, here in Revelation. So, we can be certain that these four living creatures exist, because they were already seen in the Old Testament. And what do they sing, those holy living creatures? Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. The fullness of the ice represents the ceaseless vigilance and unlimited intelligence. And the wave give them swiftness of movement. They can fly very fast. They can fly very fast around the earth. That there are four different beasts might indicate white beasts, domestical animals, human beings, and flying creatures. And these cherubims, living creatures, give praise to the Lord and adoration to his creator and savior. But they are also used by God to execute his commandments, the plagues in the great tribulation, and to destroy the earth. And here at the end we see a perfect harmony between these 24 elders, all believers, and the living four creatures, the angels of God, by throwing their crown in front of the Lord, adoring and completely adoring God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. And they all sing.
See you.